उनका सीसीटीवी कैमरा में।
अनुराग, यू आर अ कैन वेटरन एंड यू आर बैक हियर विद रमन राघव एट द डायरेक्टर्स फोर्टनाइट क्रिएटिंग बिग वेव्स। इट्स ऑलरेडी सोल्ड मेनी कंट्रीज। इज इट फॉर यू एज अ डायरेक्टर अ विंडिकेशन ऑफ सॉर्ट्स आफ्टर बॉम्बे वेलवेट?
No, I don't really see it like that, but yeah, it has actually brought me back from the dead within, in the sense, like, I feel good. And I also feel more liberated somehow. I feel more freer after...
After you made this?
...the debacle of Bombay Velvet.
How long did it take to shoot this?
This film?
Huh.
21 days?
This 20
film, we had to work backwards. We had low cost,
huh.
And low cost doesn't mean we spread it over 40 days and make it look like a low budget film. We had to spread it over 20 days with everything in our hands and make it look like a massive film. Make it look like a proper film.
Or Nawaz, you are so scary in this film. I was telling him, Anurag, that you can't talk normal with Nawaz, because he was truly disturbing.
What's your name? Pocket. It's small, right? So Pocket. कोई पूछेगा काई को मारा तुझे तो मैं बोलेगा आपने तो पॉकेट मारा बस।
इट्स द फर्स्ट टाइम आई हैव सीन यू बी दैट डार्क। तो हाउ डिड यू फाइंड दिस मैन इनसाइड ऑफ यू?
एक्चुअली मुझे तो ज्यादा आइडिया नहीं होता, लेकिन एक्चुअली सामने वालों को ज्यादा आइडिया होता है कि आदमी अंदर से कैसा है, क्या है, तो इनको ज्यादा आइडिया रहता है मेरे बारे में।
अच्छा, तो ये इनको पता था कि आप ये कर सकते हैं?
इनको पता था।
इन्होंने आप में कुछ डार्कनेस देख ली थी?
काफी चीजें देखी हैं इन्होंने।
मैंने तो इफ लाइक ऑन अ लाइक मेंस लॉकर रूम लेवल आई नो हिम इनसाइड आउट, बट ऑन द अदर वे आई नो एज एन एक्टर ही हैज सो मच टू ऑफर एंड देयर सो मच आई कैन एक्सप्लोर इनसाइड हिम। बट नॉर्मली व्हाट हैपेंस इज इनकी एक फिल्म आती है, एक रोल चल जाता है, जैसे आप लोग उनसे आके वही कराते हैं ना, तो वो भी लोग धक्का नहीं देते हैं। मुझे मालूम है करने दो, जिसको मेरी बारी आएगी मैं धक्का दूंगा, एक और नए डायरेक्शन में एक दूंगा। तो फॉर मी इट्स लाइक मेरा भी ग्रीड है, इनका भी ग्रीड है।
लेकिन नवाज, शूटिंग के दौरान कभी भी किसी भी सीन के लिए आपने कहा नहीं यार ये बहुत ज़्यादा है, ये बहुत डार्क, कभी भी कुछ, डिड यू हैव एनी डाउट्स?
सीन के दौरान डिस्टर्बिंग बहुत था। कुछ सीन ऐसे थे बहुत ही डिस्टर्ब कर रहे थे मुझे, लाइक जैसे लास्ट का सीन था और एक बीच में एक सीक्वेंस था, एक ऐसा हो गया था कि बीच में मैं बीमार हो गया था, हॉस्पिटलाइज्ड हो गया था, तो इतना ज़्यादा वो हो गया था कि मैं बेहोश हो गया था हॉस्पिटल में, अनकॉन्शियस माइंड हो गया था बिल्कुल, और उसमें भी मैं सीन जो करके आया था वो बड़बड़ा रहा था।
और कितना टाइम लगता है फिर इस कैरेक्टर से उभरने में?
मुझे इसके लिए तो बहुत टाइम लगा था एक्चुअली। मैं एक महीने तक मैंने कोई काम किया नहीं था इसके बाद, इस फिल्म के बाद मैं थोड़ा पहले अपने आप को ठीक ठाक कर लूँ, उसके बाद नॉर्मल हो जाऊँ, क्योंकि वापस से भी ज़ीरो पे आना पड़ता है ना, ज़ीरो पे आ जाए फिर देखेंगे कोई
कैसे।
हाँ, नेक्स्ट फिल्म।
तो अनुराग, फॉर यू, यू हैव सीन द सॉर्ट ऑफ इंडिया नैरेटिव एट कैन फॉर मेनी इयर्स नाउ, वेयर डू यू थिंक वी आर दिस ईयर? It's only your film and director's fortnight, it's Cinema Travelers and Cannes Classics and that's it.
Yeah, but also in the sense, you know, it's also like, I feel there's a lot of people who have no clue about the festivals. I don't know whether there's somewhere, because I feel we're making a lot of good films, but somehow or the other, they are just not going out because they don't know. So the very first festival that comes in, they give it to that. And that's a very simple thing. If your film is for an Indian film, if it premieres in an Indian festival, then it can also travel to every other big festival. But if it premieres outside India, in some smaller festival, then it won't travel to the bigger festivals. Right?
Right.
So that's why it's always advisable to you make a film, you want to test it, put it in an Indian festival, or you take it to Film Bazaar, where people are actually coming and scouting for movies. So what happens many a times, the film is already exposed, reviews are already out, people can already go on the net because it has traveled to some random festival. And a lot of films...
So they don't have a strategy?
They don't understand how it works. And plus, everybody is too much of a hurry and everybody has this strange notion. They say, festival ke liye film bana raha hoon. I don't get that. I'm saying, what is festival ke liye film bana raha hoon? We make a film, we come here so that we sell more. So we recover more money. We recover cost for the producer, so he gives me money the next time to make another film.
Yeah.
But people treat it like some sort of a strange Olympics where they think by coming here they'll win a gold medal and this and that. It doesn't work like that.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
I think they need to care more about the film. And plus, there are far too many, I think it's like the sports in India. where when the team travels for Olympics or Asian Games, they're more officials than actually players. So it's the same thing with cinema. There are more competent people, there are more people who have got nothing to do with cinema than actually filmmakers. And everybody's just walking around looking at each other. And everybody's just, I really don't know.
So we've just been joined by Vicky Kaushal, and Anurag has given him the center stage.
Thank you, sir.
So, Vicky, I was just talking to them about the making of this film, which is very good and very disturbing on so many levels. And of course, these two have a working relationship, you know, from Gangs of Wasseypur. What was it like for you to get into the mode of this character?
It was really demanding. And it was something really new to explore. I mean, it was something that I knew that I'll explore something new inside me as an actor and also as a human being. I mean, you know, what was required on the set was just to be completely naked as an actor and just completely surrender when you're there. But film ke aakhri din bhi, I remember we were walking after pack up, we were walking together and almost giving high five to each other because we were so relieved.
Exactly.
That we are nikal
through Raman and Raghav, you know, because it was so, I mean, absolutely. It was taking a toll on our personal lives also. And it was just a
Was your family getting scared?
No, but I had given them a disclaimer that, you know, when I come back from a shoot, don't ask me ki beta kuch khayega, beta kaisa raha shoot, kya kya kiya aaj, you know, how was it, did you give a one take shot or what? I was like, just let me go straight into my room and just be on my own, you know. So they were kind of prepared.
Anurag, you're ruining perfectly good people here.
I'm not ruining them, I'm saying they go, they're like,
achhe bande ho hua karte the ye.
Achha hai, logon ko feel karna bahut zaruri hota hai. They need to feel the innermost.
Yeah.
Fears and insecurities and everything. I think it's important.
But Anurag, really, final word to you. What is your sense right now as a filmmaker? You know, you said you feel a greater sense of freedom after making this film, after the whole debacle of Bombay Velvet. But what do you see for yourself going forward? You know, you're going to have this premiere tomorrow. Now what?
Now nothing. For me, I'm already working on my next few scripts. I'm already working on my next few scripts and I'm just figuring out ki ye sab festival ye sab kab band hoga aur hopefully August, September I should go into production and I think I have a lot of new films and new ideas coming up. I'm already moved on from here to there.
You're already somewhere else.
Yeah, I'm already somewhere else.
That's wonderful. Thank you all and really have a great, great premiere.
Thank you.
All my best wishes always.
Thank you so much.
If you like this video, hit the button below and subscribe to Film Companion.